Welcome back for two more examples of determining if a function is even, odd, or neither. As a quick review, a function is even if f of x equals f of negative x. The graph will also be symmetrical across the y-axis. And for odd functions, negative f of x is equal to f of negative x, and the graph has rotational symmetry about the origin, which means if we rotate the graph about the origin one half turn, or 180 degrees, the graph will remain unchanged. So when asked to determine if a function is odd, even, or neither, I always like to start by looking at the graph of the function and then verifying it algebraically. So here's the graph of a given function. Right away, we should recognize that if we were to fold this graph across the y-axis, the two halves would match up perfectly, meaning the green half would match up perfectly with the blue half, and therefore this graph has symmetry across the y-axis, and therefore this is an even function. But if we want to show this is an even function algebraically, we need to show that f of x is equal to f of negative x. The given function is f of x, so let's go ahead and determine f of negative x. So we're going to replace x with negative x in the given function. So we'll have 2 divided by negative x squared, and then minus 4. So f of negative x is equal to, well, negative x squared is equal to positive x squared, or just x squared. And notice that if we compare f of negative x to the given function f of x, they're equal to each other. So we've shown that f of x is equal to negative f of x. So now we've shown algebraically that the function is even. Let's take a look at one more example. We have f of x equals 1/4 x cubed plus x squared minus x minus 3. Again, let's start by looking at the graph of the function. We can quickly see this graph is not symmetrical across the y-axis because the two halves would not match up perfectly across this vertical line. We should also recognize the graph does not have rotational symmetry about the origin, because if we rotate this graph half a turn about the origin, it would definitely change the graph. So this graph, like many graphs, are not odd or even. Therefore, in this case, our answer is neither. Now, if we wanted to show this graph was not even algebraically, to show algebraically this function is not even, we'd have to show f of x does not equal f of negative x, and to algebraically show it's not odd, we'd have to show negative f of x is not equal to f of negative x. And for this example, let's go ahead and do that. Let's first show f of x does not equal f of negative x, meaning the function is not even. And then we'll show negative f of negative x does not equal f of negative x to show the function is not odd. So we're given function f. Let's determine f of negative x. Now, f of negative x would be 1/4 times negative x to the third plus negative x to the second minus negative x minus 3. So f of negative x is equal to, this would be negative 1/4 x to the third. This would be plus x squared plus x minus 3. So if we compare this function to the original function f of x, notice the sign of the first terms and the third terms are opposite, therefore they're not equal. So we verified that f of x does not equal f of negative x, therefore the function is not even. Now we need to show that f of negative x does not equal the opposite of f of x, or negative f of x. Well, the opposite of f of x, or negative f of x, will be equal to the opposite of this function here. So we'll just change the sign of each term. So we'll have negative 1/4 x to the third minus x squared plus x plus 3. Well, now if we compare negative f of x to f of negative x, or these two functions here, notice how the second terms and fourth terms now have opposite signs. So these aren't equal either. So we've just shown that negative f of x does not equal f of negative x. Therefore, the function is not odd. So the function is not even, and it's not odd, then the answer is it's neither, which we already determined graphically. Okay, I hope these examples were helpful.